Now the septum is this thing in the middle of the nose, goes all the way to the back of the nose. Most people can't see that they have a deviated septum from the outside. The nose looks nice and symmetric and everything looks okay. But looking inside the nose, this part of the nose, the septum, is crooked. Just because it's crooked doesn't mean that you're going to have a problem. So what are the symptoms that may be associated with a deviated septum? The most common one is, I just don't breathe very well through my nose. Sometimes they say it's the right side or the left side. One side is always blocked up, or it might be both sides. You can also have other issues associated with it, such as nosebleeds, sinus infections, chronic headaches sometimes as well. And we would evaluate all of those at the same time. My standard is, if somebody comes in, I will ask them to use a month of a steroid nasal spray, which comes only as a prescription. It's easy to use, it's two sprays in each nostril every day, but you have to use it every day for it to work. So I give them a prescription or samples if I've got them and say, go home, use this for a month, and then let's get back together. Now if they've used it already in the past, then we can kind of jump past that step. But those nose sprays can help thin the lining of the nose just a bit and help decongest the nose just a bit, that somebody could say, you know what, using that spray, I actually breathe better through my nose. If someone has a very strong allergy history to pollens or cats or whatever, and they say that they get terribly congested from their allergies, the nose spray can oftentimes overcome that. But if it doesn't, and I still think that their congestion in their nose is most likely an allergy problem, then treating the allergy is very important. Commonly associated with a deviated septum is something called enlarged turbinates. The turbinates are these curlicues of bone inside the nose. They sit beside the septum. Most people don't know they have them because you can't really look up in there very well. But the turbinates are these little lumps inside the nose that warm, clean, and humidify the air. But if they get big, then they can just block the breathing. And it's really common to see somebody with not only a deviated septum, but also enlarged turbinates. And so you treat both at the same time. If you straighten out the septum and you make the turbinates smaller, you don't remove the turbinates, you need them, but you make them smaller, what happens is you open up the nose so that there is more room for air to go in on each side, plus you allow the air to kind of go straight through the nose. If there are kinks and bends in the nose, as the air goes through, it kind of spins and it's turbulent airflow. And that can make you feel like you're not breathing very well. So you need not only to have enough air going through, but it needs to go nice and easily through the nose. And so by straightening out the septum, shrinking down the turbinates, you get that. All right, so the procedure for that is also done under general anesthesia. Also expect the person to go home the same day. That procedure takes about 45 minutes to do. It's not particularly painful. I have had a lot of people that have come back and said, you know, you gave me that prescription and I didn't even fill it because I just took some Tylenol and that was all I needed. Sometimes you may use a little plastic splint inside the nose beside the septum, but that doesn't hurt. It may be annoying, but it doesn't cause pain. And so people who come back to see me after septoplasty or fixing the septum don't talk about pain. What they do talk about is the congestion. I tell them I'm going to help their congestion, but it gets worse before it gets better. And so I tell them, look, you're going to be way congested for a couple of weeks. Your nose is going to make all kinds of excess mucus. It's going to be brown, and then it'll be green, and then it'll be clear, and then it'll be hard, and everything in between. And if you can get past that, then you're going to recover and do just great. That's what people talk about, not pain so much. There are three periods to the recovery time. The first period is how long it hurts. In most cases, for my patients, it's 2, 3, 4, maybe 5 days. The next time period is how long is it before my nose is kind of recovering and starting to get better. Between 2 weeks and 4 weeks, the nose really starts to heal up. And so I would say that there's that 2-week window where the nose is kind of really congested. And then the last period is how long is it before my nose is getting the maximum benefit. And really that can be up to 6 months. When I see somebody a month later, most of the time they say, oh my goodness, I had no idea you could breathe like this. This is great. And they're even more excited when I say, well, you're only 80% there. You still got 20% more recovery that you'll probably get over the next, you know, 5 months or so. And they're happy about that. The good thing is we're pretty nice guys. We don't have needles in the office, so you don't have to be scared to come see us. Problems that ENTs see in their office are very common. Ear infections and sinus infections, maybe a question about the tonsils and sleep and things. And so if any of these things have come to your mind of, as far as I wonder if this is something I've got, it bothers me, then just come in.